Hi, I'm Dr. Hamilton, founder of A Better Way Center, and the purpose of this seminar is to educate you a little bit about myself and our program. Goals and objectives. Describe obesity and the health effects of obesity. Describe weight loss surgeries offered at A Better Way Center. And describe the preoperative workup and post-op care that you can expect with weight loss surgery. This is not intended to persuade you to have surgery, but to give you the tools and information to make an informed decision. Only you and your family and your medical doctor, along with me, your surgeon, know if bariatric surgery is right for you. Why have surgery with us? I am a board-certified surgeon with fellowship training in bariatric surgery. Our center is involved in research in order to ensure we continue to provide the best results possible. And we have an array of services aimed at providing customized care to morbidly obese clients and their families. We genuinely want to help you reach your goals, and it's more than just surgery here. So what is morbid obesity? Being 100 pounds over ideal body weight. Using a body mass index, morbid obesity is defined as a person with a BMI of 40 or higher, or 35 with comorbidities. This is a BMI chart you will often see on the internet or in my office. The red is morbidly or severe obese. The orange is obesity with a BMI of 30 to 35. Overweight is a BMI of 25 to 30. And normal weight is a BMI of 18 to 25. What are the perceptions of society of obesity? Well, in the past, obesity was seen as a weakness or failure of an individual to diet and exercise and to do the prescribed treatments. Now, obesity is considered by a disease and named so by the American Medical Association, and surgery has gained acceptance as the only proven method to treat this disease and other associated conditions. Unfortunately, obesity is still an acceptable form of social discrimination. It still has a lot of economic costs, such as diets, foods, prescriptions, not to mention the cost of medical bills, and all its implications with having a BMI of greater than 30, such as increased heart disease, stroke, and diabetes. So what are some of the comorbidities caused with obesity? High blood pressure, infertility, diabetes, cancer, and a lot of the ones that you see listed here. What are your options? Well, diet and exercise probably everybody has tried, as well as behavioral changes. And most people only lose up to 10% of excess body weight. This is not effective long term, and most people cannot sustain this and will regain their weight. There's also weight loss drugs, and more effectively, weight loss surgery, which is where you can lose 50 to 75% of your body mass. So who qualifies? Patients with a BMI of 35 to 40 will qualify. Characteristics of potential candidates. Patients who are 100 pounds overweight, a BMI, which includes your height and weight, of 40 or more with no comorbidities, or 35 and greater with a medical problem. Most patients between the ages of 18 and 65, patients who have medical problems, and there's no behavioral health contraindications, and as long as you understand surgery and the risk. What are the most common surgeries? Currently in the US, the most common types of surgery for weight loss is the gastric bypass and the gastric sleeve. The duodenal switch is also coming into favor, and this is a great procedure with patients with a BMI of greater than 50, where we include a weight loss procedure that is restrictive and has a malabsorption procedure. The Roux-en-Y gastric bypass has multiple advantages, as well as some disadvantages. This is where we take your stomach and make it smaller, about the size of a golf ball, reroute your small intestines. With this, you have a restrictive component and also a malabsorptive component. You lose weight rapidly. It can cure and or resolve multiple medical problems. Some of the disadvantages is stomach cutting and stapling, as well as rerouting, also seen in the duodenal switch. So what is dumping syndrome? Dumping happens when essentially your small intestine receives a high sugar load content that it's not used to seeing, because usually the stomach was there. The symptoms can be rapid heart rate, headache, sweating, dizziness, or diarrhea. The gastric sleeve is one of the most popular and common bariatric procedures in these days. The advantages of this are a relatively safe procedure where we take approximately 80% of your stomach and reduce it down to 20%. This takes about an hour. We remove hormones and hunger hormones and appetite in the portion of the stomach that is removed. The disadvantages are the potential for leak, and it can worsen gastric reflux if you have it. The lap band, which was very popular in the early 2000s, is now going out of favor. But this was once a very popular method for losing weight. The advantages of this, it's a relatively quick procedure, it could be done as an outpatient, and there's minimal malnutrition risk. The disadvantages are slower weight loss, overall less weight loss, and a very high complication rate, most of which is requiring a revision in 3 to 5 years. What is revision surgery? Revision surgery is when you've had a previous bariatric surgery that may have failed or is no longer working for you, and you revise it to something else, such as a lap band to a gastric bypass or a lap band to the sleeve. We also can do a sleeve to a gastric bypass or duodenal switch. Reason for band revision. The most common is patients don't lose weight or the band just stops working, along with chronic nausea and vomiting that most people can't take anymore to certain foods such as meat and vegetables. Other complications can happen too, such as bowel erosion, band erosion, and band slip. So why is surgery right for you? All surgeries have risk. Not all patients are candidates for surgery. This is a lifelong changing commitment. So decide which surgery and which surgeon will best fit your needs. Possible risk and complications include all the risks associated with any other surgery, to include the anesthesia risk. Specifically with bariatrics, you can get staple line leaks, bleeding, infection, stricture, and ulcer. Non-surgical risk include post-op nausea, UTI, blood clots, or a pulmonary embolism. Specifically with the gastric bypass and duodenal switch, some of those complications early include death, pneumonia, wound infection, abdominal infection, anastomotic narrowing, and bowel obstruction. The late complications include hernia, bowel obstruction, weight gain, and nutritional problems, more severe with the duodenal switch procedure. Sleeve risk factors include splenic leak, staple line leak, bleeding, and death, as well as stricture, leak, wound infection. Band potential complications, as discussed, are gastro and esophageal perforation, death, bleeding, splenic injury. Late complications, as discussed, band slippage, band erosion, port infection, and with any of these, you can regain your weight if you don't attend to a regimen. So about our practice, we will have multiple visits with you. Your first visit is called the new patient visit. At this visit, you talk to me, decide if I'm a fit for you, explore your financial and insurance requirements, you'll have a brief physical exam, and we will discuss preoperative evaluations that you may need. I do not operate on anyone who smokes, so you must stop nicotine before you have your surgery. After the new patient visit, you will need several things to start the program before we submit to your insurance or before you undergo your surgery. That includes a nutrition evaluation, an exercise therapy evaluation, cardiology and sleep studies if needed, a mental health evaluation because this is going to be a huge change in your life, and the appropriate blood and lab work. I also perform an EGD to check out your stomach prior to surgery. Other requirements may be a colonoscopy, a mammogram, and any other clearances that we will discuss at your appointment. Some insurance requirements require you to do 3 to 6 months of nutrition visits. This means that you have to see the nutritionist and or me for 3 to 6 months in a row in order to meet the requirements for your insurance program. Please do not miss any of your appointments. Rescheduling only may mean prolonging your process. And multiple cancellations or missed appointments may mean dismissal from the program. We want you to be successful in your weight loss journey. Making the decision. Once your consults and tests are complete, you will have the last visit with me prior to your surgery. You will be seen in the clinic. We will go over all the test results as well as all the questions that you may have about surgery. We will discuss the risks and benefits, and I will give you instructions on your preoperative diet. The insurance approval process. After your last visit, we will begin the approval process and submit to insurance. We will need all your evaluations, diet and exercise history, as well as letters of clearance, but this process may take as long as 2 to 4 weeks. Once approved, we will contact you and schedule your surgery date. Just remember, when dealing with the insurance, it may take 2 to 6 weeks before we hear anything back with them. And everything is going to be specific to your policy. If we don't have all the requirements, it may get denied and we may have to submit some more information until we can get you approved. Helpful hints. This is a weight loss program. Any weight gain could result in prolonging, rescheduling, or canceling your surgery. Many insurances require that there is no weight gain during the weight loss program. You must give up smoking, and any cancellation or skipped appointments may just prolong the process. Recovery, hospital stay. For a laparoscopic sleeve gastrectomy, most commonly patients will stay one night in the hospital or have even gone home the same day. For a gastric bypass, it's typically one night, but you may stay two. For a revision surgery and duodenal switch, it's typically two nights, but you may stay three. Out of work time can range anywhere from 1 to 4 weeks, depending on which surgery you get. No driving until you're off all your pain medications, and no heavy lifting until you see me again in the office. At home, you must follow a specific diet. You must dramatically limit your volume, only do liquids initially, and limit the types of food that you eat in order to be successful. Do not drink liquids with meals or drink and eat at the same time. You can either drink 30 minutes before or 30 minutes after. This will be the case throughout your lifespan with a bariatric procedure. Chew your food well, take small bites, eat meals over 30 to 45 minutes, always eat on a small plate, or even use a baby spoon. So how much weight can you expect? Well, it really depends on the patient. For a gastric bypass or duodenal switch, you can expect 70 to 80% of excess weight loss, which is typically calculated on your first visit. With a gastric sleeve, you can lose 60 to 70% of excess weight loss. And with a lap band or gastric balloon, it's typically 30 to 40% of excess weight loss. But you must be compliant, and it varies from person to person. Plastic surgery following a bariatric procedure is common, but rarely covered by insurance. You must have maintained a stable weight, and then we can always set you up for a consultation. Vitamins and medications after surgery are going to be required for life. With the duodenal switch and the gastric bypass, you must take your vitamins daily in order to prevent any complications of malabsorption and not getting the nutrients you need. With the sleeve, it's also recommended that you take daily vitamins. After surgery, all vitamins and medications need to be one of the following: crushed, chewable, or in liquid form. Please ask your primary care doctor or your pharmacist to help adjust these. Pregnancy following surgery. Often patients who are struggling with getting pregnant prior to surgery with weight loss will often be fertile and get pregnant. Please, for 12 to 18 months after your surgery, wait until getting pregnant until your weight has stabilized. Once you stabilize, then I congratulate you on your new pregnancy. Please discuss with me your plans on having children. We encourage you to join a support group and maintain participation with that support group for the best success after your surgery. Ideally, you should attend the ones that we offer, but you can also join your own online groups or have support groups that you create. You must remain and continue to exercise. This is very important before and after surgery. Surgery is only a tool to help you reach your goal. You must do your part as well, which includes changing the types of food you eat and exercising daily for 30 to 45 minutes. We can also help you with this by providing an exercise or physical therapist as part of our program. The next step in pursuing your weight loss goal and a healthier you is making an appointment with me to discuss your options. Please feel free to bring a family member with you and a list of potential questions you may have about your surgical options. Weight loss surgery is a journey and a lifestyle change. At A Better Way Center, we make sure you have all the tools you need to make this happen and look forward to going through this journey with you. Make an appointment today and let us show you a better way. Hi, I hope to see you soon. I hope this was helpful and we'll talk more at your appointment.